Hi, I'm Li Hao. Let's talk about component life cycle events. There's four life cycle events. There's a on mount and on destroy. And then there's a before update and after update. So let's take a look at some examples on how you can use them. So over here, I've prepared app.svelte and I have a component. So this component, I have import on mount, on destroy, before update, and after update from Svelte. So in each of the lifecycle, I try to console out the lifecycle name. So in the console, you see that when you first mount your components, there will be three events fired: before updates, and then on mount, and after updates. So do note that before updates and after updates will be fired even if you are just mounting your component. And on mount will be fired when you try to mount your component, right? Right after all the elements, like the buttons over here is being mounted, then on mount will fire, and then after updates will fire as well. So if I come over here in the component and I try to add a if statement, if condition, and if I try to have a checkbox that I can toggle on and off the condition, checkbox bind check, then if I turn it on, you will see that it's called mount. And if I turn it off, you'll see on destroy being called. Okay, let me try that again. I clear. If I turn it on, before updates, on mount, and after updates. And if I turn it on, you see on destroy. And within the component itself, I have prepared a button which will update the count over here. So if I click on the button right now, then I will update the count and it should kick in an update cycle. So if I click here, you will see that before updates and after updates. Although you can't really see the timing that when this is being called, but according to the Svelte documentation, it says that before updates fires right before you update the DOM. And then after update fires right after the DOM has updated. And in the docs, it says that it will after update will fire once right after the DOM is updated. So it has this word once, and I was curious, like, why is it so? And it's because if you come over here in after updates, you could possibly go and update the state again. And if this happens, this actually kicks in another round of updates on your component. And this could lead to an infinite loop if it's not carefully handled. And somehow apparently Svelte handles it by make sure that after update only called once throughout the whole update, right? So if you kicks in another update cycle in the after updates, you will go updates again, but then after update will not be called again. So I'm not quite sure whether this makes sense to you, but for as far as I can see, this does help prevent infinite loop, recursive calls. So the Svelte version that I'm using right now is 3.35. So this behavior stays at this current version. So if I click on over here, you can see that before updates, on mount, after updates, and this kicks in another round of updates. So you see that before update being fired. So if I click me again, you'll see that before update, after update, and before updates being called. So this is something weird, but of course I wouldn't expect you to actually change the state in after updates. That is, you shouldn't do that, right? So that is one edge case that I want to point out over here. And you can see that I'm calling this component, calling all these lifecycle methods to register the event, to register a callback. So you call this on mount or any of this, and you pass in a function. So this function will be called at the right point of time. And you can only call You can only do this registration during the component initialization. What that means is that you have to be written at the top level when you're trying to execute this whole script over here. So if you do it something like, do it slightly later, for example, if I say set timeout and call it at the next timeout, then what you have actually is an error. It will say that function called outside component initialization. You have to call it during the component initialization. But that does not stop us if we come up with a function over here, foo, and we make sure that we call the foo during initialization of your function, which is calling it at the top level over here, then of course there's no error, right? So it's not about where this onMount has to be, it's more about when you should call it. You should call it during your component initialization. This is because whenever a Svelte component is initializing your component, Svelte is initializing your component, it knows which component is initializing. So you're importing onMount, onDestroy before update. You know that you're importing this function. This function has no idea. These functions are so-called is importing from Svelte, right? So you has to know that what are the current components being initialized. So you have to call it during initialization so that it knows that, oh, the current component is being initialized is this, and I want to register this event, this onMount or onDestroy to this component. But once it's finished initialization, then you couldn't find that component anymore, and therefore you get this error of you have to call it during component initialization. So one last thing that I want to share is that one great use case that you could use when it stems out from this, where you can actually call this somewhere else. Meaning actually you can have a function, say foo, right, in this case, and save it somewhere else, some foo.js, and you export this function. And so for each of the component that wants to do something during onMount, for example, calling onMount, you can import foo for all of these components. So there's ways that you can reuse lifecycle logic. So you call foo from here, you can have multiple components and import foo. And when you have to call it during component initialization, but then this will make that any component that you call this will have a one callback registered for onMount, and which is to print out the onMount during onMount. Right, sorry, it's a bit mouthful, but yeah. So one example I can think of is to have this function called markupdate. Let me show you how I can use this. I can import, let's remove this. I can import markupdate. And call it over here. And this function actually returns an action. Curious why, right? So I'm going to say action. So this action can apply to any element. Use action. And you will see that my element will have a outline drawn on top of that element, right? This is done by the action. But anytime when I change something, it turns red. The outline turns red. So there's no way that this action will know that something has changed, right? Because there's no way this action, we are not passing any parameters to this action, so there's no way for it to know. But one curious point is we are actually creating this action on the fly over here, this markupdate. So over here, markupdate, I actually call the before update. For any component that I call this, I'm actually registering something in the before update so that I know that this component is updating. And what I do for the action is actually just add this element that I apply the action to a set. so that every time when something has updates, I draw a red outline to that element, to all these elements. So that is one interesting use case of where you can have before updates or unmounts being called within a function, and you can reuse logics of them, right? You don't have to write this within the component itself. You can write it in other functions, but make sure you call them during component initialization. So I would love to see any other interesting use case that you would come up with by using a component lifecycle. Comment down below, share with us, right? Don't be selfish. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.